Led by Markey Cancer Center researcher Teresa Fan and published in the Journal of Clinical Investigation, a new study suggests that targeting a key enzyme in the metabolic process may lead to novel drug development for lung cancer.
What makes cancer cell is it has ability to grow faster. It can survive various adverse conditions, bad conditions that a cell normally faces when you grow too fast. If you compromise our ability to produce energy, the cell will not be able to continue to survive. Or if you have a way of enhancing energy production, like cancer cell does, if we can detect that, that gives us a functional meaning of the marker that we can find.
Using non-toxic, naturally occurring stable isotope tracers, Teresa Fan, Andrew Lane, and Rick Higashi's team marks and tracks atoms through metabolic pathways. Hunter Mosley's team then uses bioinformatics to analyze this data to identify metabolic changes.
Stable isotope tracer includes something like C13, M15. These are naturally occurring in our body. Because of low abundance in our body, if we enrich it with, say, a C13 labeled glucose or C13, M15 labeled glutamine, we can track these atoms through the metabolic transformation process. By looking at the end product, we cannot backtrack what reaction has occurred that allows us to detect whether cancer cells can alter their metabolic pathways. That could be hundreds to thousands of such labeled compounds that we track. And that gives us a lot of power in trying to reconstruct the many different pathways in our body.
This study is the first to trace metabolic changes directly in lung cancer patients, which may lead to more targeted, less toxic treatments.
We actually done so far more than 120 patients, so we have a pretty good database built. The important thing about studying human patients is that we often study in the laboratory models, like the cell model, or animal model. They never can really reflect true human metabolism or human pathology. So by studying human subjects directly, we are a lot closer in understanding patient. We so far found that individual differ in their metabolic reprogramming, depending on how the cancer was initiated and how it evolved. Some are resistant to certain drugs, some are sensitive to certain drugs. By understanding these differences, we believe we can help physicians to administer better drug therapy. We can really come up with novel therapeutic strategy, hopefully that will be more effective, at the same time less intoxicating.
Understanding cancer metabolism also has the potential for early diagnosis. Metabolic changes occur before the structural changes physicians look for with medical imaging.
The NIH is very interested in combining image-based diagnostic tool with other tools such as biochemistry to try to make the early diagnosis more robust. So we can come up with really early detection methods that are minimally invasive or non-invasive. So far, lung cancer detection still involves pretty costly and often invasive method. We actually are working on a diagnostic method in collaboration with a company in Australia to use the lipid profile in plasma to be able to come up with a robust way of diagnosing lung cancer and breast cancer early. And data looks pretty good so far. Dr. Mark Evers is, I would say, a leader that gave us a lot of confidence in his ability to bring the Markey Cancer Center into the next stage. He was very enthusiastic about cancer metabolism areas of research. He convinced us that this is the place that we can really extend our capability. And he also provided brand new state-of-the-art facility housed in this beautiful biofarm complex that we can get everybody together and work as a team. What we're most excited about is generating a holistic, fundamental understanding of lung cancer and perhaps other cancer. We are collaborating with other people in colon cancer or breast cancer or pancreatic cancer or kidney cancer. The same approach could apply to all these different cancers.